Step 12. The Quabblist is absolute master of the microcosm and the macrocosm, and with the preceding step, the particle development and training of a perfect Quabblist has been, so to speak, completed. In this step, the 12th and last step of this work, I want to express some retrospective ideas regarding the building up of the whole system and give a summary of the whole course. Above all, the Quabblist could convince himself that the preparation by the three sense concentration recommended in my first work, Initiation into Hermetics, was very necessary in order to achieve a certain high grade of concentration of all three senses for a certain period of time, which then enabled him to utter aletta quabblistically, that is, to work creatively therewith. The Quabblist was taught, one after another, how to impregnate his mental, astral and physical bodies by means of single letters in order not only to take up certain oscillations within himself, but also to evoke these in different planes. Furthermore, he was taught by frequent repetitions and practical operations, to give a letter the dynamics power of expansion necessary for his quabalistic work. Likewise, he attained the faculty of working inductively and deductively, that is, of condensing and decondensing, that is, of bringing about effects in the mental matrix, astral kingdom and in the physical body, the material world. In doing this, he has appropriated to himself not only the quantitative faculty of expansion of the mental, astral and the material body, but also the ability of giving the individual powers, quantities, their analogous qualities. Not until having learned this, did the letter uttered by the Quabblist become magic, that is, dynamic and thus creatively effective. Thereby he has enlivened the regions appertaining to the elements, strengthened the powers therein in analogy to the universal powers, thus bringing them into line with each other. His microcosm, that is, the miniature world, has been brought into perfect harmony with the macrocosm, and the Quabblist has taken full account of this legality in accordance with the Hermes plate, which says that which is above is also that which is below. Having achieved the faculty of bringing about mental, astral and material effects, he has become absolute master of the word in all three kingdoms. For a Quabblist who, like the Creator, can create everything by the word, nothing is impossible, so that he is able to bring about, by the word, any effect in the miniature world, the microcosm, if necessary, and divine providence having permitted or ordered it, also in the universe, the macrocosm. Furthermore, the Quabblist has learned to build up vaults and to know all the legality and analogous equivalents with regard to the micro and macrocosm, and to master them. His faculties and powers have increased in a colossal manner and might not be described by mere words. It stands to reason that his responsibility has increased thereby, too. For as soon as a formula is transferred into the Akasa principle, cause and effect are no longer subject to destiny but exclusively to the highest divine providence. A genuine Quabblist, and also a true magician, for magic and Quabbala go together, who has achieved this state of maturity, will never lend himself to merely fulfilling the material wishes of others or to merely gaining personal advantages from his practical experiences. His sublime wish will be to serve mankind and, wrapped in silence and humility, he will never want to demonstrate his maturity. He will not be induced by any situation to violate the laws of divine order. Although he is able to do anything, since he is a servant of God and a high initiate, he will always do what divine providence orders him to do. Usually, a Quabblist who has proceeded thus far is entrusted with a high mission to mankind, or he is given permission of further increasing his consciousness by penetrating deeply into the so-called spheric Quabbala, which has to do with the application of cosmic formulas with regard to the other planes. Thus the Quabblist will be able to use more than a fourfold key, and he will be initiated into the further leaves of the Book of Wisdom, the tarot cards, not only theoretically but also in a practical sense, providing he conscientiously follows the will of divine providence. A spheric Quabblist who is able to bring about Quabblistic effects in the whole cosmos can neither be understood nor comprehended by ordinary mortals and immature people. Having reached this stage, the Quabblist neither needs personal guidance nor a book with instructions, specifications and keys. Such an initiate is already a true adept whom neither a book nor a mortal being can tell anything. It is then up to him alone to disintegrate his ego consciousness in divine providence, since he has achieved the highest perfection, and may go into divine providence, in all his aspects. However, before such a state of perfection is reached, the further leaves of the Book of Wisdom have to be worked through practically. I have not been permitted to reveal these and make them accessible to systematic working methods, for mankind is not yet mature enough to grasp such profound mysteries of divine providence by intellect and to digest them intellectually. Certain laws cannot be comprehended by mere intellect at all and are only to be conceived by personal universal consciousness from the standpoint of wisdom. I should, however, be very pleased if I were permitted by divine providence to reveal at least two more leaves of the Book of Wisdom in order to help the most talented ones on their way. It is left to divine providence alone to decide on this.